My name is Petur Thor Sigurdsson, Product Director for LS Omni and LS Pay. Let's look at the architecture of LS Pay. If we start by looking at the big picture and align on terminology, then a typical card-present transaction starts at a merchant, where a customer inserts his or her card into a payment terminal, normally referred to as a PIN entry device or a PET. The authorization request is then channeled to the payment service provider, or PSP. The PSP is the entity LS Pay integrates with, and this is also the entity that sources the payment devices to the merchant and provides the payment gateway. So the PSP is the entity that the merchant negotiates with and provides first-level support to the merchant in the case of a faulty PET, for example. Now, examples of PSPs would be PayEx, which is an Ingenico dealer. Then we have AltaPay and WorldPay, which offer a selection of payment device brands. And then Verifone, which is a PET manufacturer itself. Next in line, the PSP routes the authorization request to the respective acquirer, also known as a processor in the US and Canada. It's common practice for PSPs to support multiple acquirers, like for example PayEx, which is a Nordic PSP, which supports both Nets and Swedbank as acquirers. And just to make things interesting, sometimes the PSP and the acquirer are the very same entity, such as is the case with WorldPay and Nets. Now, if we look at how we've been doing integrations to payment service providers in the past, then the integrations have always been built natively in every single solution. Meaning that if we wanted to integrate with, let's say, Verifone, we would need to redo the same work for every single solution we have here at LS Retail. Basically, do the same integration 4 to 5 times. Now, this is obviously something that could be improved on. And therefore, we have come up with the concept of the LS Pay engine. So what we have here is a new single point of entry for all our retail and hospitality platforms when it comes to payments. This means that all our solutions simply integrate once to our LS Pay engine, and then the engine contains multiple plugins where each plugin contains an integration to a specific PSP. On this architecture diagram, we can see how things might look in the Nordics. Our retail and hospitality platforms simply contain the LS Pay engine, and then the engine contains the plugins for all the supported PSPs in this region. That is, one plugin for PayEx, where the plugin knows how to operate the card payment terminals supported by PayEx, and also knows how to communicate with PayEx's payment gateway. And then, in the same fashion, we have plugins for both Verifone and AltaPay. Now, let's look at how our solutions integrate with LS Pay and which platforms are supported already. The first thing to realize here is that the role of the LS Pay team is to create and maintain the LS Pay engine and all its integrations with PSPs. But when it comes to integrating with LS Pay, then each respective platform team has the responsibility of wiring up the LS Pay engine into that particular platform. So, where are we currently? What's the status on each platform? If we start with LS NAV, then we are seeing two kinds of integrations based on which version of LS NAV applies. For the web POS and LS NAV versions 2018 and onwards, we will see support for the pay engine built through the new hardware station. On the other hand, for existing versions, that is versions 2017, 2016, 15, and 13, we will build support for the payment engine through the traditional EFT code units. Now, what this means is that LS Retail will deliver FOBs containing the integration to the LS Pay engine on version 2016 of LS NAV. And then our partners can easily merge this code into other versions as needed. The LSNAV team estimates to support the LSP engine in Q2 this year. If we move over to LS1, then the LS1 team estimates to release support for LSP in Q3 this year. Further moving on to LS Omni, then we have already released support for LSP on our mobile POS. And next on the agenda is to look at LSP from the e-commerce side. And last but not least, we have LS Express and LS First. LS Express have already released their support for LSP, and the status for LS First is that they are looking into supporting LSP, but the timeline has not yet been set. Thank you.